Good morning, children. Welcome to all in class 7th. Now, I will teach you science chapter 1, nutrition in plants. As the name in nutrition, nutrine means nourish. It means the process of taking food and its utilization by living things is called nutrition. The food is taken by us, the food which is taken by us, it is used in playing, jumping and other kinds of activities. So that is, this process is known as nutrition. Now there are two modes of nutrition. First is nutrition are of two types, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Firstly, I will define you autotrophic nutrition. As the auto means self, trophos mean nourishment or to make. It means self-made food. So you, we can know, okay, we know that green plants make their food themselves. The plants, you know, the plants or organisms which can make their own food, they are known as autotrophs. The mode of nutrition in which organisms make their food from simple inorganic substance. Simple inorganic substance mean water and carbon dioxide. They are known as autotroph. And this mode of nutrition is known as autotrophic nutrition, such as green plants and some bacteria. As you have discussed in class, we have discussed in class 6 also about the process of photosynthesis in which plants make their food. Plants make their food, that's why they are known as producers also. Green plants make their, we can see in the figure here, green plants, they take light in the form of sunlight, in the form of light energy, carbon dioxide which is inhaled, which is released by human being, and they are taking carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and chlorophyll, the green pigment which is present in the leaves, and due to the presence of green pigment, the color of the leaf is green. And in these presence, in the presence of these all substances, green plants make their own food, and from roots they are taking water and minerals. These are the raw materials of the plants. So this, for the process of the photosynthesis, these all things are required, and in this process they release oxygen gas. Oxygen gas is released in this process. So the process in which green plants make their food, here we can see the process by which green plants make their food in the presence of sunlight, in the presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll, is called photosynthesis. We can see the equation here: carbon dioxide, water, H2O, sunlight, chlorophyll. These water and carbon dioxide and water are known as the raw materials. In the presence of sunlight and green pigment chlorophyll, they make their food and form carbohydrate C6H12O6 and release oxygen. And during the process of, during this process, oxygen is released. This, it forms carbohydrate and oxygen is released, and the carbohydrate ultimately get converted into starch. Starch, the process of the presence of starch in leaves indicate the presence of photosynthesis. We can test the starch test in leaf also with the help of iodine for testing the starch. And this, we can see that leaves are known as the food factories of plant, because these contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. That's why they are known as the food factory of plants. Instead of leaf, other parts of the plant such as stem and the green sepals, they are going to also take part in the process of the photosynthesis, because they all are of green color. All the parts of the plants do not take part in the process of the making food, process of photosynthesis. These are the main part of the plant, as I have told you. That's why they are known as the food factory of the plant. Now we can see here ki instead of green color, there are so many other colors of leaves such as green, brown, yellow. These leaves can make food or not? Yes, they can make, because the large amount of red, brown and other pigment marks by the green color. But they contain chlorophyll and they can also make food. They can also prepare their food by the process of the photosynthesis. Now, leaves contains tiny pores which are called the stomata. We can say that the tiny pores which are present on the lower surface of the leaves are known as stomata. And these stomata, we can see that figure of stomata. These are, if we will be take a peel of a leaf, lower surface of the leaf, and we will be keep into the slide, and if we will observe under the microscope, we can see such kind of stomata. These stomata, they contain guard cell and chloroplast. This chloroplast helps in the photosynthesis, in the manufacturing of food. It is a open stomata and it is a closed stomata. These guard cells protect the stomata. What are the use of these stomata in the leaves? These stomata helps in transpiration. Transpiration, we know ki if we want to cool our body by sweating, like that plants also excess amount of water is released from the plants in the form of vapor. This is called transpiration. And second, they help in exchange gases. Carbon dioxide is taken by stomata and it is then oxygen is released. So these help in exchanging of gases. Now this our topic is over, and heterotrophic mode of nutrition we will discuss tomorrow. Now, there are some questions which you have to write. What are autotrophs? Second, name the raw materials needed for photosynthesis. Third, what are known as food factory of plants and why? Fourth, define photosynthesis with the help of diagram. Here you have to define the give the definition of photosynthesis, then you will draw diagram and the equation which I have told you here of carbon dioxide, water and formation of carbohydrate and oxygen. If you have any queries, you can ask me in my number. Yes, thank you.